So let's install NiFi on Windows machine. In order to install NiFi, first we need to download Java as described in the Apache NiFi documentation section. So what I will do is I'm going to download JDK 8 and since I have 64-bit machine, I'm going to download 64-bit software. If yours is 32-bit, you can download the relevant software. So now the way to check whether the Java is already installed on your system or not is you can go to the command prompt and there you can type Java, and if it shows error message like command not found or something, it means Java has not been installed on your machine and you should be following this step to install the Java. And if you already have Java installed, then probably you can skip this step and go on to the second step of installing NiFi. So Java software has been successfully downloaded. I'm double clicking on this in order for this to launch the startup of the installation. As you can see, the installation wizard has opened. So the installation of JDK is pretty straightforward. I'm not going to make any changes, just going to keep the default thing selected and going to click on next. So here pretty much we'll be just clicking on next and then finish on whatever windows which is displayed here. Click on next. While this is in progress, let's also start downloading the NiFi software. So for that one, you can on Google you can select download NiFi and then click on the first link. From here, go to the binary section and select the first link. So just click here and it will start the software. Since I have already downloaded the software, I'm just going to cancel it because I have already downloaded this software and kept into the D drive. So I'll be showing that to you. So you see here, once you download NiFi, it will be showing like NiFi and the version number ended with .tar. So once you extract it, you will be seeing the extracted folder which is displayed here, NiFi along with the version number. If you go inside that, this is your NiFi home directory. Inside this you have bin directory. Okay, so so our Java installation has successfully completed. Let's see and let's make sure and validate if Java has successfully installed. For that we can go to command prompt and write Java, and yes, this time we don't get the error that Java is not found, so this is good enough. And now we can go in again back to the NiFi folder and go inside the bin directory. And from here click on run-NiFi. Just double click on it and it will launch the startup process. So usually it takes around 5 minutes in order for this software to start. It also actually depends on the capacity of your machine. So mine one is not much high-ended server, so it just has couple of GB of RAM, so it is going to take probably around couple of minutes for NiFi to launch. And inside the log folders you can keep tracking the progress of the installation and startup. For now I am not going to go into more details of these log files, we will be discussing these in next videos. So usually when NiFi is installed, it inside the NiFi home directory, it creates four repositories. So we can go back to NiFi home directory and see whether those repositories have been created. Okay, so right now we don't see anything new, any new folders coming up. So the installation is still going on and it is processing. As soon as that is about to finish, we should be seeing additional four directories which is related to repository. Also, let's try to do HTTP localhost followed by the port 8080 and see if we are able to open NiFi. So right now, as you see, we are not able to open NiFi, so it has still not been installed. Guys, one thing you should make sure, you should never close this window, because as soon as you close this window, this command prompt, the software startup process is going to fail. So once NiFi starts also, you don't need to close that command prompt. You can just minimize that and then you can continue working on the NiFi. So I'm still waiting for some new directories, repository directories to be seen under NiFi home directory. Seems it is taking little longer than usual. Alright, now you can see database repository, content repository, flow file and provenance repository has been created. So if you get any pop-up related to this public network, you can just click on cancel. We don't need to make any changes here. So now as we see our, you know, we have repositories created and now we should be able to go inside, go to NiFi localhost and it should be able to launch. Alright, as you can see, we already have this NiFi up and running now. Let's also create a small flow to test whether NiFi is also able to process some data. So I'm going to create two processors, one is generate flow file and the other one is log message. So generate flow file dynamically, generate some random data, and that one I'm going to just connect to log message. So right now you don't need to know about more details of these processors, I'm going to describe it to you in later stage of the videos. So in the generate flow file, I'm going to make some configuration. I'm going to change the scheduling to 10 seconds, so it will generate one file after every 10 seconds. And then in the properties, I'm going to change the file size from 0 byte to 1 KB. And in the custom text, I'm going to give some data. So whenever it is going to generate that file, the file will be containing this data. So this is just a quick way of passing huge amount of data to your processors in order to do some kind of testing if you do not have any file ready. And also it is a good way to validate that NiFi is working properly. So I'm just entering some dummy data, we don't need to bother about data at this point of time. We'll be doing all this in more details in our next videos. So click on apply. Now I'm going to start this processor and hopefully it should create a flow file along with the data in that. So I'm not starting log message because I want to see the data in the queue. So the one which you see with the name success is the queue. we are going to right click on that and going to click on list queue. Inside that we are going to click on view content in order to see the content. So as you can successfully see, we have been able to create a file and also insert some random data to that file. So it means NiFi has been successfully installed.